John, do you got a dream opponent or something? Somebody who would like to fight? But I would just say just like these big names like Canelo or something like this. I mean, realistic guys like in Germany or something like that. Somebody who holds a belt.
Somebody holds a belt? You know who I want to fight? The one dude who was disrespectful from that one chick. He was disrespectful. Hey, Chris, what's that guy's name? The one who's been an asshole on the interview? What's his name?
From
the States.
I don't know of assholes.
Huh? No, from Detroit. What's his name? He just, like, really pissed me off, you know, but...
Detroit?
Yeah.
Boxer.
He was like, you're talking trash, because remember Yildirim came to Detroit to fight him. And he was talking trash, Yildirim, his trainer, and the lady who asked him a question and stuff, but... Okay, well, that's the guy
would like to fight him.
Yeah, I would like to fight him, because he was just being an asshole.
No, he was an asshole to you?
No, just to the people that we know, but it's just no reason for that in the fight and stuff, you know, I hate that stuff. But I don't have a dream opponent, I like to fight anybody with the belt.
You're fighting at middleweight, right?
Yeah, middleweight. I can fight anywhere. Middleweight, super middleweight, junior middleweight, I can
fight. Are you open the German boxes here?
Yes and no. Like, nobody really.
Nobody, you know Vince Vaughn?
Yeah, I know, but that's my homie. I know Vince Vaughn.
So you wouldn't fight Vince Vaughn?
No, I wouldn't fight him unless I have to, you know, because I used to train with him before, back when we.
Before
did
you spot
him? Yeah, I spotted him. Dude, he's like
he's tough, right?
Yeah, he can hit.
Yeah.
He's a beast, you know what I mean? But.
Yeah, like he's fighting a super middleweight.
Yeah.
He's a big dude.
That dude's huge. I don't know how he makes weight, because you walk around, yeah. he's like this, you know what I'm saying?
Yeah.
But he's cool people. It's like
crazy athletic.
Yeah, I don't know how he does it, but he miracles the weight easily. So,
yeah.
But I know him. I know Errol Schwartz.
Errol Schwartz? I don't know.
Ahmed Ali. I was gonna try to fight Ahmed Ali. I thought that'd be good.
Ahmed Ali, you want to fight Ahmed Ali?
That'd be a cool fight, cause like he lives in Ludwigshafen, I live in Mannheim. You know,
yeah.
We have like a battle.
You attached to that camp. You know them, right?
Yeah, I know them. Yeah, they're good people.
That's a good fight to make.
I think that'd be a great fight, because
this fight would be a junior middleweight or a middleweight.
I didn't fight in junior middleweight. That's okay. That's actually my weight class.
You saw Abbas Barou? He's fighting a junior middleweight.
Yeah,
he's the black dude.
Yeah, yeah.
That's a big talent. You know what I mean?
It's a big talent. That'd also be a great fight and stuff too. You know what I'm saying?
I'd like to see you both fight, because you're a slippery guy, difficult that.
Yeah, I'm a slippery guy and he's a powerful guy. So you got the. It's like the tortoise and the hare, you know, the dancer versus the power guy. So it's always a fighter versus boxer. It's always a good fight. So those would be a great fight, you know.
Another German fighter, your favorite German fighter, who's active right now? I don't know.
My favorite German fighter is active, I'd probably say Kukai. Jack
Kukai. Damn, he's a beast. I like him.
Yeah, he's a cool guy. You know why he's a cool guy? Because he actually writes me back on Instagram.
Yeah.
But he's cool people and stuff. And Raja Mesh. Raja, she's a female boxer, but I learned so much from boxing pro. Because like a lot of her techniques, she showed me back when I was first coming up. And then I was able to use them and stuff. And then, so yeah, she's another German boxer that's pretty cool.
That's cool.
And then,
I mean, Jack Cook has a guy who was fighting in middleweight, a junior middleweight, so that's a good fight, I think.
Yeah, 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 he's on another level.
And he got a very good amateur pedigree here.
Yes.
Very good fight against Danilchenko.
Yes.
And Andrade he fought.
Yes.
And he showed good performance.
Yeah, that dude, he's a beast. He's on another level. We're watching his training videos.
I think from all German fighters, he deserves.
Yeah, I thought he had one. I don't know if he had one or not, but yeah.
He didn't have one. Not a real one.
Yeah,
he
yeah.
All these interim belts, he got that, but real.
Yeah, you know, that's because
I don't think so. No.
When people got the real belts, they don't want to fight the best people because they don't want to lose it. You know, that's money. You know what I'm saying? So it's all business. So they got to be able to make it worth it. And it's hard to do that in Germany, you know. So.
Yeah, we talked right now about amateur pedigree. Do you have amateur pedigree? Did you fight
amateurs? Yeah, I fought amateurs.
In America or in Germany?
America and Germany.
So tell us the story. How you were a soldier here in Germany.
Yeah.
And when you started to box?
Okay, I started like a couple years ago. I think I was like 5. Okay, so like I used to box in America. I boxed in D.C. at Midtown Boxing Youth Academy, and I boxed in Morris Park Boxing Club. But the problem was I was always bigging all the kids in my weight class, so I couldn't get so many fights. So when I came to the Army, I got some amateur fights. I did like these smokers and stuff, so they don't really count. And then I joined Heidelberg Box Club and Street Sign Box Club, and I was able to get some boxes on the fights on the German side. And then at the same time, I got my USA Box Pass again, and then I got some more fights. So then I did the All-Army Boxing Team. So I did the All-Army Boxing Team and the German fights and stuff. And of course, I could, because I'm not German, I can't do like the German championship, so I can only go so far in these tournaments and stuff, but I would do that. So overall, I think I got about 55 or 60 amateur fights, you know. So it's like I came out like, yeah, 50 and 55, you know. So I think I have an all right pedigree and stuff, you know.
And you got this American boxing style.
Oh, yeah. That's what I was telling you earlier. Like that's what made it better for me, because the Germans here, they need space to do their punches. So if you crowd them, it makes them crazy and stuff. So
yeah, so they struggle a lot with this American style.
Yeah, they go haywire. They start swinging. And then you just wait for them to get tired, and then you can just fight them and stuff. So, but the thing is, I didn't know that when I was first fighting amateur. I was fighting dance, so I just like move all around. They get so tired of the fight, trying to catch
you.
Yeah, yeah. Because that's a cool thing about being hyperactive.
Yes. So footwork is very important, but not too much. So you get tired.
It depends on who you're fighting.
Oh, okay.
So if you fight somebody who walks like this, you don't need much footwork. If you fight somebody who has good footwork, then you gotta have good footwork. So you have to be able to trap them and make them do what you want to do. So it just all depends. Like some person, you might have that power. Some person has to be able to have the box. Maybe you gotta have footwork. Some people have to have all three. Some people just gotta have patience and stuff, you know. So it just all depends. You gotta like look at it.
Boxing IQ, no?
Yeah, it's the boxing IQ. Not just the boxing IQ, it's the plan.
Right. Make adjustments.
You gotta better make adjustments on the fly. Your team has to see something, and you have to be able to apply what they tell you to do. So,
how important is a good team for a boxer?
That's the team is more important than the fighter, honestly, because the team, they can construct something.
Yeah. So, yeah. I mean, in the team, that's a cop man, that's a boxing trainer, that's a cardio trainer, that's a nutritionist.
Yes.
But there's a lot of people, you know.
There's a lot of moving parts. Part of it. Everybody only see the boxer, but they don't see everything else. They don't see the guy saying, hey, you better eat this. They don't see the guy making like the appointments and the meetings and stuff. You know, they don't see the promoter like talking to people like 2 o'clock in the morning trying to get stuff. They don't see the media people like doing hours and hours of film studies and cutting films and stuff. Or the people putting that stuff, nobody sees that. All they see is the boxer. But there's like about 25-30 people together who's working really hard to make this fighter be the best he can be. So the fighter is just a small part. It's like he's like he gets the glory, but it's so much people working so just as hard as the fighter that you don't get to see so often.
Do you think there are a lot of very talented fighters that didn't make it because they got a good team or somebody didn't pick them up, a big promoter?
There's a lot of great fighters out there, because you gotta have the great team, you gotta be the right place at the right time, then you gotta have the right matchups. So, and you gotta fight the right matchups at the right time. Because, for example, like Lomachenko, his first loss, he didn't have to fight that fight, but it made him popular, you know? But it had to be somebody else, they have that loss, they don't have it, so it just all depends. So you gotta have somebody who's like really good at calculating, picking your opponents at the right time and stuff.
On the other hand, he learned a lot from his loss.
He learned a lot from his loss, but it helped him more than it hurt him. But there's other people, they took a loss in their career and it hurt them, they went so far down. So it just all depends, so.
Yeah, losing is also important in boxing, I think. You can't always win, you know?
Yeah, you can't always win. But the problem is like today's fans and stuff, they think the second you have a loss that your fight's over. And as you see, perfect example, a couple weeks ago, J-Rock just beat Hurt, you know?
Yes, man, that's amazing, man.
Nobody was expecting that.
Everybody was riding him off.
Yeah, I'm from D.C. I had Hurt all the way. He had to come out with the skin stuff. I was like, I was going for Hurt. But yeah, J-Rock came in and he won. And everybody thought, oh, because he lost in the...
The same thing with Tony Harrison and Jermell Charles.
Exactly.
And look, that was a big upset.
Exactly.
I mean, to be honest, I had to fight very close.
Yeah.
But, you know, he did his thing. He outboxed him a lot of rounds.
I was hoping it was going to be a draw, you know, but I'm happy to even fight again, so I know it's going to be a great fight.
Yeah, but he pulled always a fight because of the injury.
Yeah.
So I hope they will do this rematch.
Yeah, me too. I hope so too. I hope so also. So that's going to be a great fight.
The middleweight is very stacked right now.
Yeah.
Look, you got Jermell Charlo, you got Tony Harrison,
yep.
You got J-Rock, you got Hurt,
yep.
You got the Honeymoon Gear. There are a lot of dudes, so a lot of talented dudes. Joey Spencer is coming up, I saw him.
Yeah.
I don't know if you know.
I've seen a couple of his fights.
Also with Erickson Lubin.
Yeah,
there were a lot. Maybe Errol Spence or somebody will move up to a junior.
Yeah, I don't think Errol Spence should move up. He doesn't have to move up just yet, you know. He can still fight where he at.
Yeah, he needs to collect, first of all the belts.
Exactly, yeah.
Make clear that he's the best in the welterweight division.
Yeah.
But this will be very difficult to make a fight.
I think so.
Politics,
huh? Because of politics, and then you got to think about it, like, where are they going to have the fight at? Is it going to be in Vegas? Is it going to be in Texas? Is it going to be in New York? Because Crawford always fights in New York, you know? But, you know, Spence, he don't want to fight in Texas, you know, so.
They need to find a neutral place somewhere. I don't know where, but.
Yeah, there is no neutral space for him, you know, so.
Yeah, I mean, Dallas, I don't think they find it in
Dallas. At the Dallas Stadium, because he's.
Yes, but they wouldn't make the fight in Dallas. I don't think so. They want the neutral place.
Exactly. That's the thing. That's what's always gonna stop them. They're gonna. That's probably what'll stop the fight. But I mean, I would love to see that fight.
I hope this fight must come up next. Yeah. After Porter, I was better as Porter. I think
that's gonna be a, that's.
But because it does look like Crawford, Thurman wants to talk with him.
Exactly. Now let's check it out. Okay, so now you got Spence and Porter. How do you think this fight's gonna play out?
Man, that's a. In my opinion, that's a very close fight.
Yes, because
a lot of people they're writing Porter off. Because of his last opponent against Ubers, it was a very close fight. Some people had Ubers winning, but I think Porter is a very, very good fighter.
Porter is a tough fighter, tough guy out of Cleveland, and he comes straight forward, and he's like nonstop pressure. So you gotta either be on your racehorse, or you gotta be like in some phenomenal shape to sustain
it. If Spence stops Porter, this would be phenomenal.
Yeah.
No, he would be.
I don't think he'll stop Porter. It's gonna go to distance, but yeah.
I think it's very close. I think maybe split decision, something like that.
But what about then you got Pacquiao versus Thurman?
Pacquiao, easy.
Hey, yeah, I got Pacquiao too.
In my opinion.
Sorry, Thurman. I'm friends with Thurman on Facebook, and I used to talk to his old coach, but I'm like, I don't know. It's just because it's Pacquiao. He's too quick. Yeah. You know, he comes in, blah, blah, blah.
And Thurman does not the same, to be honest, in my opinion. In the Jose Lopez fight, he didn't look good.
Yeah, but he had a long time off, so that was the thing with Thurman. The thing is, okay, Thurman still got the power. At the end of the day, if you can knock somebody with either hand, you don't have to look the same. You come look at the Donacini. All of those Donacini's have was that left hand. It was a hell of a left hand. You can put your lights out anytime.
But let's say Pacquiao beats him. What's next for Pacquiao? Is he going to retire? Going to fight Mikey Garcia? Who? Danny Garcia?
Pacquiao, he'll fight at least maybe five fights. I don't think he's going to retire. Because it's in
it.
Yeah, because it's in on the key fighting, you know?
To be honest, it doesn't look like he wants to fight on his pants. I mean, after the Mikey Garcia fight, he was in the ring.
Yeah.
But he didn't look like, it looked like he wanted to Mikey Garcia to fight him.
Yeah, you know why? Because Pacquiao versus Errol Spence isn't worth as much money as Pacquiao versus Garcia.
That's because of his background, his Mexican.
Exactly. Because he's looking at it when Pacquiao had to fight in Dallas Stadium against Claudio. He's thinking, okay, I can do something like that. Or they can fight in Mexico City or somewhere. Or even the Philippines.
Yeah.
But that's the thing. But
Spence is popular too,
right? He's real popular. But
pay-per-view with Mikey Garcia.
Oh, yeah. But see, thing.
But he's dangerous also.
He's dangerous, but it all depends on who's fighting who.
I think stylistically, this could be a horrible matchup for Pacquiao.
Of course it could be.
Because Spence is the guy who's coming forward, he's pressuring, and he's big.
And he's accurate, yeah.
And he can hit. To struggle with Jeff Horn when he was
Okay, now shakes out. Pacquiao beat Jeff Horn. I don't know how they had Jeff Horn. That fight pissed me off. I was like, wow. I had to stay up like early in the morning to watch that fight. Pacquiao won that fight. You know, they say, well, he won that fight. I don't think it really. I think Pacquiao was like, okay, you know, I'm not gonna make this guy look bad and stuff. You know, I'm a Hall of Fame, so he probably felt bad for the guy, and then he didn't. You didn't see the true Pacquiao, but Pacquiao won that fight. I don't know. You know, he's like, yeah, I'm a co-star, but he won that fight. I don't know that.
Yes, he won, but he didn't look like the Pacquiao we know.
Yeah, because the guy was just holding him and stuff. You know, so. Yeah. It's like some days it's like that, you know. You don't always have your best days when you get in the ring, but that don't mean you're not the good, you know.
It's kind of sad that they never had a rematch.
Pacquiao would kill him in a rematch.
Yes, I think also.
Because Pacquiao would be hungry for that rematch. I mean, yes.
And you look at what Crawford did with him.
Exactly. That was Crawford. So imagine Pacquiao already fighting a guy, knowing what to expect, will fight him again. So.
Yeah. So there we have it.
Yep.
Thank you. Kevin came, man.
Anytime. Thanks for doing this interview with you and stuff, you know. Eddie, you having these dope videos and stuff. So check them out at fightingnow.de on Instagram, Facebook, YouTube. I think that's all. I don't know if you got Twitter, but yeah. But all right, yes. Maybe you can put the little thing right here on the fightingnow.de. All right, bro. Thanks.